Hi, this is Sai Saushikti and I'm a legal intern at Lexan Company. Today I'm going to discuss about a very famous case named as R.J. Anand versus Deluxe Films. This was a case of 1978. This was basically a case of copyright. If we go through the case facts, then judgment, we will get to know about the copyright concept. We know that from the beginning that copyright subsists in expressing the ideas. Copyright doesn't protect the idea itself. If the ideas are being expressed somewhere, then copyright works over there. But we cannot protect the ideas only. In someone's head, there is an idea and that will be protected under copyright. Because we don't know, who has what ideas and how can it be unique and qualify all the distinctness. When it is properly expressed, then only they are protected. And secondly, that the copyright have a lot of doctrines like sweat and draw, minimal creativity. This doctrines also apply. One cannot copy the whole thing. If it is copied the whole thing, then it is infringement of copyright. But if there is a small part which is very coincident way it has been copied, then copyright doesn't exist over there. So if I write a article and the substantial part that is very important that is copied, then the other person who is copying it is liable for the copyright infringement. But the basic ideas, the known facts, if it has been copied or it has been by mistakenly written by them, the infringers, then it is not copying, because those are the facts and that cannot get the copyright protections. So basically the case over here was on this. So plaintiff over here was R.J. Anand. R.J. Anand was the playwright by profession and he wrote many plays and was a dramatist. He wrote a play named Hum Hindustani in the year of 1953 and successfully he restaged this play in the year of 1954, 1955 and 1956. As he saw that this play is gaining a lot of popularity among the people, then he wanted to take this play to a bigger platform. That's why he contacted the defendant. Defendant didn't show any affirmation from their side. So in the year of 1955, in the month of May, when the defendant came with the film called New Delhi, the defendant asked whether this film was same that of the play that he wrote. The defendant denied, and then when there was a release of the film, that was in the May 1956, the plaintiff found that it was same that of Hum Hindustani and he sued the defendant for the copyright infringement. Over here was whether there was any substantial resemblance that was there between the plaintiff work and the defendant work. The court over here came with the conclusion that there was no substantial resemblance between the plaintiff and the defendant work. To have a copyright infringement, there should be a copied form of the substantial part. The two works were different, that of the plaintiff and defendant. Moreover, copyright can only be given in ideas which are expressed. The ideas which are not expressed cannot be given copyright protection. Moreover, there was no substantial similarity between the work of the plaintiff and work of the defendant. As there was no substantial copying of the work, the action of infringement cannot be brought off over here. So this was the case of R.J. Anand, in which we learned that copyright can be protected in ideas which are expressed. It cannot be given to ideas itself. So that's it. Thank you.